Hi, Dr. Mark Brehenigan of AskTheDentist.com. Probably one of our most frequent questions and topics of discussion on AskTheDentist.com is the dry socket. So, and of course, it's all focused on how to prevent it. So instead of, that's another video, I'll talk about how to prevent it. But I think if you know what a dry socket is, that will help you understand the whole prevention aspect of it. So real quickly, a dry socket is the hole that's left behind after you take a tooth out. It sounds obvious, but a lot of people don't think of it as that. And in the old days, we used to just leave it at that, and a blood clot would form inside that socket. But it's kind of a soft, kind of squishy material until it hardens, and bone integrates into that blood clot. And for those 3 or 4 days, that blood clot can fall out. It can get sucked out from drinking from a straw, cigarettes, inhaling, swishing, spitting, and of course a lot of physical activity. Or bending over and coming up quickly, anything like that. Ultimate Frisbee is a no-no. Nothing like that after getting an extraction. They also recommend not having alcohol after an extraction, and that's not a big issue, but what they're worried about there is the blood thinning effects of alcohol. So you don't want to brush the area, you don't want to jump up and down, you don't want to move quickly, no sports for 3 or 4 days. You want to keep that blood clot in there. But now, the standard of care in dentistry is to put a synthetic bone graft into that socket. And there's less likelihood of, because of the bone graft, the material, the density, how it's placed, perhaps it's covered up with some sutures, chances are you won't get a dry socket if that's done. And I would recommend that. So if the surgeon or the dentist gives you an option of the bone graft, you should do that. There's nothing worse than a dry socket. In the next video, I'll tell you how to prevent getting a dry socket, and that's what everybody wants to know. We'll save that for another video.